anaitwa Domitla Chesang. Kwake hii ni siku kama siku nyingine tu. Ameamini sana katika kujikita kuwahusisha wanajamii kupiga vita ukeketaji. Manake anaamini kidole kimoja hakivunji chawa.
I work with IRA Foundation, which is a community-based organization that we use as a platform to talk to the community, to educate the community on the health implications or the negative implications of FGM, child marriages and other forms of gender-based violences like abduction. This is a CBO that has been working across West Pokot County, also to empower the girl child through education.
Itakumbukwa kuwa kaunti ya West Pokot ukeketaji wa mtoto wa kike bado unafanyika, jambo ambalo ni kizingiti katika elimu ya watoto.
Now during COVID-19 last year when it first hit, there was rampant, there was a rise in FGM cases all over most parts of central Pokot, and so IREP Foundation took it upon itself to come and empower people on the hazards, the health hazards that comes with FGM, because it's a recipe that leads to child marriages, especially in this area.
Mnamo mwaka wa 2011, serikali ya Kenya ilipitisha sera katika bunge la kitaifa kuharamisha ukeketaji wa mtoto wa kike. Kupitia mradi unaojulikana kama Global Media Campaign, wanaharakati zaidi ya 30 kutoka kona tofauti hapa nchini wamefaidika na mafunzo ya kuwafikia wanajamii kupitia njia za kiwanahabari. Domitla Chesang, ambaye pia ni mshindi wa tuzo ambayo inatolewa na Malkia wa Uingereza, ameamini katika kutumia mkakati wa kufikia jamii moja kwa moja. Aidha, ameendelea zaidi na kuwahusisha hasa wazee kuwapeleka watoto wao hasa wa kike shuleni.
So we are here to conduct a father-daughter dialogue. We are here for a very special forum which is just about to start, and this is where we are bringing fathers with daughters to share a platform or to converse, to discuss about issues affecting them, and especially from the fathers, from the daughter's side. So in this community, I'm from this community, so we never get a chance, as a girl child, you never get a chance to sit down with your father, to discuss with your father. So we wanted to bridge the gap. We wanted to strengthen the relationship and enhance the relationship between a father and his daughter. So this is going to be one of its own or one of its kind that we've ever done. And we really hope that through this initiative that we've just started, we'll be able to convince the fathers of these girls to take more active roles in the lives of their daughters, because this hasn't been the case before. So we wanted also the girls to be able to not to shy away from sharing their issues with their fathers. So we are going to just have a very simple kind of a conversation, and the girls are going to sit with their fathers. They're going to introduce their fathers, and their fathers are also going to introduce their daughters. Then from there, they will have like a one-on-one conversation. And then from after that, we'll be able to hear back from the girls and hear back from the dads on how it has been like for the very first time sitting down with your father and talking to your dad, something that has never been witnessed in this community. Because in this community, they believe that children or the girls the mothers are responsible for their daughters.
Huyu hapa ni mmoja ya wazee ambao wameamini kwamba masomo kwa mtoto wa kike ni kitu muhimu.
Bola gaso la gitepa mana school gasa ambo tini ka wega paka ya lu to muni ja school ka ngara ka nyaman ambo isi u joko se jaga dengan
mona harakati huyu ana imani kubwa kabisa kwamba wakati ambapo unaihusisha jamii, basi utapata matunda bora, hasa wazee hawa wakihusishwa, manake wao ndio ambao wanafanya maamuzi.
We really hope that this approach can work, because we know that it's faster when men make a decision, because they will just be like, yes, okay, we'll take the girls to school, and that is it, because nobody else will question their decisions in the home.
Haya ni makala ya My Story.